So we continue our presentation using, and now we're going to take a look at the TikTok social media platform. So TikTok in China is known as Douyin, and it is a video sharing social networking service owned by a Chinese company called ByteDance. The social media platform is used to make a variety of short-form videos from genres like dance, comedy, and education. And the videos generally range from 3 seconds to 1 minute. When you think about TikTok, I want you to think about karaoke for the digital age. It is a platform where they can come and they can sing, they can do videos, they can dance, they can engage in these types of activities. Yes? So, today, TikTok is one of the most prominent and valuable startups. The video sharing app was downloaded 1 billion times and count 500 million active users per month. On average, users spend approximately 52 minutes daily on TikTok, and the app is popular particularly among teenagers who make up approximately 41% of TikTok users, and they're between the ages of 16 and 24. TikTok's primary revenue source is in-app purchases that bring the video sharing app $3.5 million per month. And in the first half of 2019, global TikTok revenue reached $39 billion. Now, signing up for TikTok is also very easy. First, you have to go to the Apple Store or the Google Play Store and you download the TikTok app. Now, as children, you are reminded that to download any social media apps on your devices, you must get parental consent. Without parental consent, you are not supposed to be on these social media platforms. ChildLine does not promote children disobeying their parents when it comes to online engagement. But if your parents have allowed you, this is how you do it. You go to the Apple Store or the Google Play Store and you download the TikTok app. Once downloaded, you sign up with either your Facebook, your Gmail, or your Twitter accounts, or you can create a username and password using your email address. So the image that you're seeing on the right side there is basically TikTok's homepage. Now, by default, TikTok is going to assign all users a unique username made up of a random collection of letters and numbers, very similar to what you experience when you're creating an email address. If your handle is used by someone else, you won't be able to use it. It will offer you recommendations and you choose one that is suitable for you. Now, big question, should children under 13 use TikTok? TikTok, if your younger children want to use the app, there are sections of the app for persons under 13 that will include additional safety and privacy settings. Now, TikTok, once you've logged in, you'll be brought to your homepage, and now it is time for you to edit your profile. So when you click on the bottom right-hand corner, if you see the cursor moving around here, right, where you see me, you tap that and it will take you to your profile. This is your profile interface, so to speak. And then you click Edit Profile. Once you tap Edit Profile, it will take you to this interface, which will now allow you to change your TikTok profile picture. Now, TikTok allows you to choose between a static image or a video. So the choice is yours. The next piece of the TikTok puzzle, so to speak, is creating your bio. Now, your bio is basically where you could just put a little bit of information about yourself, or some people put links to their other profiles in their bio. And TikTok would allow you to have up to 80 characters in the bio. So as you can see on all of these pages here, different, you have Netflix with their bios, you have this at later with their bio, and so on. And you can see that it connects persons to different fan pages, different social media platforms, they have little websites and links in their bio so that persons can easily access different content that they may be promoting. Now, TikTok. Now that your profile is set up, it's time for you to follow users and to engage with the content. On TikTok, you don't necessarily have to follow accounts to see their content. Most of the content is going to appear on your personalized For You page, which is the home page that I was talking about. Now, following accounts and engaging with TikTok content will let TikTok know what you're interested in, and it will help TikTok's algorithm to create a personalized For You page. So if they notice that you watch videos on education a lot, they will post or show you a lot of videos about education. If they know that you're participating in the dance challenges, they will show you the dance challenges because they want to keep you coming back to the app. Now, on TikTok, you can share videos, your own videos. To share a video is very easy. All you have to do is tap the plus button that you would see at the bottom of your screen. Then you choose the length of the video and the template that you want to use. Depending on how long you want your video to be, you tap 15 seconds or 60 seconds. And when you tap templates, you can choose to record using one of TikTok's pre-made video templates. You want to choose effects for step 3. Step 4, you select a sound if you're having that in the background. And step 5, you will film or upload your video. Now, TikTok challenges. TikTok challenges can be both organic or sponsored, and they're often a combination of three elements, which is text, sound, and movement, which is usually a choreographed dance. They can be started by individuals who are usually TikTokers or influencers with many followers, and a TikToker is a person who is using TikTok. Or they can be created by brands that have invested in TikTok advertising. Now, there are thousands of challenges that a person can do on TikTok, and some of the challenges are harmless or safe, while others can be considered dangerous. So these are some of the safe challenges. Persons are required to post two photos of themselves, one being recent and the other being at least 10 years ago. This is called the Then and Now challenge or the 10-year challenge. And it's a very safe challenge. And as you can see, 1.7 million people have already joined this challenge. People have evolved it or manipulated it to include food. So you can see this image of the chicken here in the before and after stages. You also could see this image of this dog in the then and now stages. So yes, people also use their plans to participate in this challenge. There's also the over 30 or the over 40 challenge, where persons are required to post a photo of themselves once they are over the challenge age. So if it's the over 40 challenge, you show the over 40 challenge. If it's the over 25 challenge, you post a picture of yourself if you're over 25. There's also the firstborn challenge, which is where persons are required to post a photo of themselves once they are the firstborn child in their family. And then you put the hashtag firstborn challenge, which is pretty safe. And then you have something called the sibling challenge. And this is where members of the family will gather and a series of questions would be posed. Members of the family must point to the person who the scenarios best describe. So here's a look.
Who got the most whoopings growing up? Who got in the least amount of trouble growing up? Who is the rebel child? Who made better grades in school? Who talked back more? Who is the funniest? Who is the most expensive child? Who is more financially responsible? Who goes out more? Who spends the most money on unnecessary things? Who will get married first? Who will have kids first? Who has the most style? Who has had the most boyfriends or girlfriends? Who is the meanest? Who is the loudest? Who is the sneakiest? Who is more caring? Who is the overdramatic one? Who is the overprotective one? Who would be the last to leave the house after they're grown? Who will put y'all in a nursing home?
All right, so that there is the sibling challenge, which is pretty safe, and this one can be fun for families to enjoy. You also have the pretty face challenge, and in this challenge, once you think you have a pretty face, you post it with the hashtag, pretty face challenge. So, what are your thoughts on these safe challenges? Do you think they're exciting? Do you think they're boring? Do you think that this is something that you would enjoy? And I'd encourage you at this time to, you know, pause this video and write down your thoughts so that you can get an idea as to what you think about it, why you may engage in it, why you may not engage in it, and so on. So, and it's a good opportunity for you to converse with colleagues or friends about this particular topic. But while we have the safe challenges, there are also those that you do not want to get involved in. And these are the dangerous challenges. And unfortunately, they are seemingly more popular. Why? I am not certain, but they do carry a level of risk that can have temporary and even permanent consequences for the people who participate in them. Not just the people who participate in the challenges are actually at risk, but also other people. Yes? So let's take a look. First, we have the silhouette challenge. And in this challenge, which is one that's trending a lot right now, persons must take a record of themselves with clothes on. Soon, the song and the video background will change, and the person is expected to be naked to display the silhouette of their body. So this is the silhouette challenge, where basically the person shows the silhouette of their body. But what we've understand is that there are persons that who are tech savvy enough who can use apps or filters to remove this particular filter on this. And when they remove the filter, what does that mean? It means that your naked body is going to be exposed. There was actually a bus driver in the United States who lost his job because he participated in the silhouette challenge while he was on the bus. He participated in it and he lost his job. Yes, and parents sometimes need to get a little bit more involved. So here's a young lady who wanted to participate in the challenge, but little did she know. And that's the parents' involvement in that particular challenge. Then you have the Skullbreaker challenge. It involves three people standing next to one another in a line. When the person in the middle jumps in the air, the people on either side kick out the legs of the middle person. The dangerous challenge has led to many skull injuries, including fractures and concussions. And several people have been hospitalized as a result, while a few people have actually died from doing the challenge. Sadly, the middle person in these videos often wasn't aware of what was about to happen, and many people have spoken out about the bullying that is linked to these videos. TikTok has actually taken all Skullbreaker challenge videos off of the app in an attempt to discourage people from trying it.
It's the latest viral craze, causing injuries across the U.S. and the globe. This morning, the urgent effort to stop this cruel prank on the popular app TikTok. Two people fool an unsuspecting third into jumping into the air, kicking their feet right out from under them. The challenge, aptly named the Skullbreaker.
I couldn't get up because I couldn't feel my hands, I couldn't feel my legs, my feet, nothing. I was numb.
13-year-old Kathleen De Jesus, a target of the challenge, rushed from her Lawrence, Massachusetts middle school to the hospital where she spent 2 days for a severe concussion.
I was screaming that I needed an ambulance. I was thinking like, oh my God, I'm going to lose my life for this game. I should have never done it.
In Portland, Oregon,
the seniors asked me if I would jump for their TikTok video.
Another victim, 14-year-old Olivia Ross.
I hit my head on the ground really hard, and I remember like blacking out for a second, and I started to get an instant like pressure headache.
The potential long-lasting injuries now has medical professionals posting their own videos warning people, especially young ones.
The types of head injuries can be anything from a skull fracture to a full-out concussion and even paralysis.
It's not the first challenge on TikTok to cause harm. The outlet or penny challenge has sparked damage and even fires. The popular social media app tells ABC News user safety is a top priority, and they do not allow content that encourages or replicates dangerous challenges that might lead to injury.
All right, so that's the skull breaker challenge. Then you have the concussion or the throw in the air challenge. And for the throw in the air or the concussion challenge, a group of people stand in a circle with their heads bent in to form a huddle. The group then throws an object into the air, and nobody in the circle is allowed to move until after the object lands on someone. The object, which can range from a small ball to bigger items, including a bike, usually hits one of the people on the head or the neck. The goal of the challenge is to cause a concussion. Here's a look. So you see, they're throwing a chair into the air, and they're quite entertained. They're throwing these wires into the air, that metal bar thing. They're throwing the broom. They're throwing a bike. They're throwing the entire basketball hoop. Imagine if these things actually hit you, it can cause permanent damage. So that's that. Do not try these things at home. The penny challenge, another challenge that has caused a lot of problems. The purpose of said TikTok trend was to slide a penny behind a phone charger that was partially plugged in. The resultant spark was the quote-unquote fun of the video, but it also led to several fires. While it doesn't seem like these fires led to any fatalities, the risk far outweighed the reward.
The penny challenge circulating on TikTok can be dangerous, firefighters warn, referencing this specific video as an example of what not to do.
Trend on the popular app TikTok is actually causing fires.
This challenge is damaging schools and putting teenagers in danger.
A letter from the state fire marshal in Massachusetts addressed to firefighters across the country said, the challenge involves using the plug part of a phone charger, partially inserting it into the wall outlet, and then sliding a penny down the wall onto the exposed prongs. The result is sparks, electrical system damage, and in some cases, fire. The letter adds, this video is a concern and similar to past viral videos that encourage unsafe behavior. People are warning of the dangers in the comments of this TikTok video example now on YouTube. I actually did this and my parents thought I plugged it in wrong. My living room power went out, so I went to the fuse power box in hopes of getting it back. One person wrote, seriously, don't try this, people. I don't think your parents want to go through that, especially if your fuse breaks. My son just did this and blew out the power in half our house, another person wrote. This burnt outlet was the result of students trying the challenge in a school.
They could have set fire to part of the classroom or any books, papers, or anything in a particular area. And they could have shorted out the electrical system in the building, and they could have had a fire going in the walls of the building.
They're now facing charges. For InsideEdition.com, I'm Lee Sheps.
You hear that? They're now facing charges, which is a challenge. So they're facing charges and challenges. You see, he blew out the power in his house. This person also engaged, and his update is that the power is out. Stuff not working properly. So you see, you have to be very, very careful. The charger slide challenge. This is a car challenge, which is very similar to the Kiki challenge or the Drake challenge, which is a challenge where people had to step out of their vehicle and dance with the door open while the car was moving. And for those who participated in this particular challenge, the cha-cha challenge, that is, cha-cha slide challenge, you would drive your car to the lyrics of the cha-cha slide. Yes, that very popular song that is played at basically every wedding. And the challenge had the potential to cause cars to veer between lanes, flip over, or even crash into other vehicles. Here's a look.
And to the left.
So of course there are a number of risks involved with this. One is a violation of driving codes. You're endangering the lives of other people on the road. You're endangering your own life. You're endangering the lives of the people who are inside of that vehicle with you. So things to be mindful of. Then we have the cereal challenge. And the rules are fairly simple. You're going to use someone's mouth as a cereal bowl. This is what people are doing now. That's right. People were pouring milk and cereal into another person's mouth while they laid down, and then they used a spoon to eat it. The cereal challenge is posing a huge choking hazard, especially when the users start laughing. This TikTok challenge has yet to be removed from the app, but it still is not a good idea.
All right, let's make a bowl of cereal. Open up.
So you see, wasting the cereal, because all of that has to throw away. Wasting the milk.
I need some more milk.
Look. Look, he can literally drown his friend in that, and he's laughing. Here's another one. So as you can see, a very, very dangerous challenge to participate in. Then we have the blackout challenge. While versions of the challenge have been around, have been popular for many years, with people holding their own breath or constricting their airways for several minutes at a time, this challenge involves snapping your head back and forth from side to side more than a dozen times. Without fail, the users pass out after this head sway. In some videos, the person attempting the challenge has elevated the risk by attempting it on a staircase. And unfortunately, trigger warning, this article contains sensitive details of a case where a 9-year-old attempted the challenge and lost his life. So I encourage you to pause the video and have a little read of the article, or you can do additional research on your own time. But in Trinidad, Trinidad was not the only country to experience a death following this challenge. A 10-year-old girl in Italy also lost her life doing this blackout challenge. Here's a look.
Italy is slapping a ban on TikTok users who haven't verified their age after a 10-year-old girl died in a horrific blackout challenge on the video sharing app. The online game involves people choking themselves to temporarily pass out, but the Sicilian youngster was found dead in her bathroom.
The medics did everything they could to bring the child back to life, but unfortunately, although the heart immediately started beating again, the brain had been starved of oxygen for too long due to the strangulation. After a few hours of irreversible coma, we concluded she was brain dead.
TikTok insists that users' safety is a priority and it bans any dangerous behavior. But an Italian lawyer specializing in online cases told us social networks, in his view, must do much more.
Clearly, the story of this little girl is truly tragic. It makes us reflect on the role of social networks in the lives of minors. Yes, parents must pay attention and control their children, but there must be social control over the content that minors can see on these networks. A social network cannot just say a minor has stated that they are old enough to use the app. They should check it. If, after verification, a child accesses the platform and sees violent content, the social network would be responsible. In this case, it's necessary to determine whether the TikTok social network really has some responsibilities, whether this video of the child was actually viewed by TikTok or not. The Italian Data Protection Authority has opened an investigation against TikTok into this because it's trying to understand whether access to minors is actually legitimate and legal.
So there's another challenge called the Bright Eye Challenge. And in this challenge, it's supposedly a way to give yourself lighter colored eyes. You're instructed to take jelly, which should not be by your eyes, hand sanitizer, which should not be by your eyes, bleach, which certainly should not be by your eyes, and shaving cream, which also should not be by your eyes. And you pop all of those things that should not be by your eyes into a Ziploc bag. Once completed, you hold it to your eyes for a minute. Please do not go and try this. It does not change the color of your eyes. What can happen is that you can damage your eyes, not just temporarily, but also permanently. And you can cause blindness in whichever eye you try this. These are very, very strong and toxic chemicals that should never be placed in or near your eyes. So please do not engage in this challenge. Then there's another one called the Benadryl Challenge. And in this challenge, persons asked or encouraged to take large doses of this particular antihistamine. The aim is to induce a hallucination, and persons take at least 12 tablets, of course, possibly resulting in them overdosing and having to go to the hospital to get their stomach pumped. There's also the jalapeno challenge, and in this challenge, persons are required to consume a very spicy product. Now, this challenge, some people say it's not that dangerous, it's not that safe. There's a debate in terms of how safe or how dangerous it may be, and I accept that, I note it. But if you know that you're not a spicy person, you don't eat products of that have a lot of spice in it or pepper and so on, please do not engage in this. Even if you're a pepper sauce eater or hot pepper eater, please be mindful. Do not try eating 5, 6, 7, 10 hot peppers or jalapenos just for the likes and for the views, because this can cause a lot of damage to your mouth and even to your stomach. And please note that WhatsApp is also a platform that you need to be careful with. So we've gone through several challenges from TikTok, both safe and unsafe. Please use your discretion and always let your parents give you consent before you decide to participate in any of those challenges. Now, just a quick note on WhatsApp. Since May 2018, and many people don't know this, WhatsApp also has a minimum age to use, and it is 13 years old. Why? Because WhatsApp has many echoes of features that other social networking platforms have. These include having a profile picture, being able to share a status or share stories. You're able to share photos, videos, voice notes. You're able to do a lot more, update a bio. You're able to create, use emojis and so on. So you have to be extremely, extremely, extremely careful when engaging in any of these TikTok challenges. Any of them or even when you're using WhatsApp, because sometimes links are sent through WhatsApp that could be dangerous. And once you click those links, it could corrupt your phone, it could corrupt your device, because WhatsApp could also be downloaded on your tablet or on your desktop or on your laptop. And once you have that malware in the system, it steals your files, corrupts your files, damages your device, and you don't want that, especially when these days our reliance on technology is greater than ever. So always be mindful of these little challenges.